Hey guys, my name is Ellen Fox. Welcome to my channel, and today we have the trailer of Love, Death Plus Robots, Volume 3. How many languages can you count in?
Myself. I am the only one who can keep this ship on a straight keel. You need me intact.
Voyaging through strange eons of thought. I'm trying to communicate.
What the fuck is that?
The soldier's not fucking archaeologists.
The Swarm is a perfect organic system. We can bring order to the chaos of human expansion.
The fuck is that? Evolution is forcing the animal kingdom to adapt, etc., etc.
What exactly is a tech millionaire?
It's a lot like a regular millionaire, but with a hoodie and crippling social anxiety.
Should we shoot it?
Fuck yes, Coots, let's shoot it.
And then robots killed them.
This looks so good. I remember when I told someone that my very first animated show was Arcane, they were like, oh God, now you're going to have such high expectations and every other animated show is not going to be good enough for you, because Arcane was literally perfect. Like the storyline, the acting, you know, the voice acting and the animation, everything about it was literally perfect. So I was a little worried. I was like, am I never going to like an animated show ever again? But then Love, Death and Robots, my God, it is so beautiful. And the thing that I love about this is that it's like at the very brink of animation and reality. Like there are moments when you're like, that is not even animated. That is a real human, or that is a real thing. It's just so, it stands at like this very thin strand between live action and animation sometimes, and it just blows my mind. This music is literally so popular every time it comes. Like I have heard it in so many trailers and every single time it slaps harder than Will Smith, but not harder than my mom. 9 new stories. That is a lot of new stories, especially because I heard that they are planning on continuing the stories of 2-3 episodes from the first volumes. So I was excited for that, but now 9 new stories, you have me invested. And this kind of restores my faith in Netflix, because they're still realizing that these are some good shows and we must not cancel them. That being said, I am sometimes glad when Netflix cancels some shows, because like Lucifer, for example. I don't know about you, but season 6 of Lucifer was the biggest disappointment I've ever had in my life. That was literally the worst thing I've ever watched. So I would have been really happy if they had just canceled it at season 5, ended the story there. So if you cannot continue a story well, please end it. There is no need to drag it. You can make money other ways. I'm sorry, you can. So if you cannot make a proper sequel, do not do it. So with this, it looks good. I'm really happy. So please continue it. If you can, do it justice. Otherwise, drop it. Thank you. Spare us.
I am the only one who can keep this ship on a straight keel.
This gave me major Shadow and Bone vibes with the whole traveling through the barrier and in the ship and like the Darklings coming in. And was he the Darkling? I think he was called the Darkling. I was in love with the Darkling. So I'm really excited for this story particularly.
What the fuck is that?
The soldier's not fucking archaeologists.
I'm still not used to animated characters swearing, probably because I watch a lot of cartoons, but this dialogue was amazing. We're soldiers, not archaeologists. This comes in second. Oh my god, look at her! Her entire building, the jewels, the scream, everything about this. If I did not love Shadow and Bone so much, I would put this first. Maybe we should just put it first, like, I don't love Shadow and Bone that much. It's the Darkling that I love.
The fuck is that? Evolution is forcing the animal kingdom to adapt, etc, etc.
Dear God, I hope they adapt. Because literally, all humans do is hurt animals and plants. I really hope they adapt and do something about this, because humans would not save them. So I think it is time they start saving themselves. I said what I said. I want zebras to grow fangs and just kill every hunter out there.
What exactly is a tech millionaire?
It's a lot like a regular millionaire, but with a hoodie and crippling social anxiety.
I wish I was wearing a wig because I want to snatch my hair off right now.
They were mean to robots and then robots killed them.
Don't show this to my mom. She already has a growing fear of technology. That being said, when the robots under attack by cats last time, I was expecting to see a cat skeleton. That being said, the other day I saw a dead cat by the road. And you know, after you die, your body becomes stiff, rigor mortis. And she was dead, but in a very odd position. And for her privacy's sake, I will not tell you what position it was. So that was it for this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed. And if you did, smash the... Oh. Some YouTubers really tell you to smash a like button. No, that's not my type. I don't want to smash any like buttons. Just like it. Click it. Slightly. Also, so comment below and let me know anything you want me to know. And also subscribe, click the notification bell so you'll be notified every time I upload. And also follow me on my Instagram and Twitter. They're both at Elna Fox. And yeah, that is it. I'm the only Elna Fox in this world. And do you own a cat? Let me know. And bye. It's when we leave and all I really wanna know. When we leave and all I really need to know. Is when we leave.